This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. Here's our next uniform motion problem, a rate times time equals distance problem. Remember, rate times time equals distance. A pilot flew from one city to another city, averaging 150 miles per hour. So that's its rate. Later, it flew back to the first city, averaging 100 miles per hour. So that means it's going slower on the way back. The total flying time was 5 hours. How far apart are the cities? All right, so we want to represent this pictorially. So first, it's going, right, to a city, and then it's turning around and coming back. So by the picture, you can see that those should be the same distance, right? Flying to a city should be the same as flying back. I don't know how far that is. In fact, that's the question, how far apart are the two cities? So let's do a little chart to put our rate, time, and distance in here. Rate, time, and distance. All right, what do we know? We're talking about going and then returning. So do we know the rate going? So we go up here. Flew from one city to another one, averaging 150. Yes, the rate going was 150. And then going back on the return trip was 100. Now do we know the time? All we know is the total flying time. The total flying time was 5 hours. So we did another problem similar to this. So if it's like 1 hour going, then it'd be 4 hours back. Or if it's 2 hours going, it'd be 3 hours back. Or if it was 1.5 hours going, it would be 3.5 hours back. You have to let one of them be x. And all we know is it has to add up to 5. So you have to think x plus what is going to add up to 5, and you can solve for the box by subtracting x from both sides. So it's 5 minus x. So in other words, if the answer was 1, if x was 1, then 5 minus 1 would be 4. 1 and 4 would add up to 5. Okay, this is one that throws a lot of people off. Might need to practice that a little bit more. So now we know rate times time equals distance. So going, the rate times the time is 150 times x, or 150x, right? We're doing rate times the time. Now the return is 100 times this whole thing, 5 minus x. You need to put that in parentheses. So it's 100 times 5 minus x. Now that's not simplified, so let's go ahead and simplify that first. So I need to do the distributive property. 100 times 5 is 500 minus 100 times x is 100x. So once you fill in the distance here on the chart, you can go back up to your picture and fill in how we're representing the distances up here. So going, the distance is 150x. So we can put 150x right here. And on the return trip, we simplified it, so we could write that as 500 minus 100x. And now by looking at the picture, can you write an equation? Hopefully you can tell this is the same distance as this. So the equation we're going to have to solve is 150x is equal to 500 minus 100x. So let's do that. 150x, because that is the distance going, is the same as the distance returning. All right, so now we need to solve this equation. So we need to get all the variables on one side. So how about we add 100x to both sides. And that gives me 250x equals 500. Oh, it's going to come out to a nice number. Divide both sides by 250, So that x is 2. Now, what did x stand for? So look at the chart up here. Here's where we defined x. It was the time going. So the return, well, if it's a total of 5 hours, if the time going was 2, then the return trip would be 3 hours to get a total of 5 hours. So let's make up that chart again, but we're going to put in the actual numbers and make sure everything still makes perfect sense. We have going, returning, our rates, our time, and our distance. And we knew the rates already. That was 150 and 100. But now I know what x is. So if x is 2, this is 2. I know it was a total of 5 hours, so that must be 3. Or you could do it like this, 5 minus 2. Yes, that's 3. And rate times time equals distance. 150 times 2 is 300. 100 times 3 is 300. So I think that was the idea, that it would be the same distance. So you look up here. Sorry. So if you want, you could actually just draw the picture again, going, returning. What it's saying is this 300 miles and that's 300 miles. So yeah, everything makes sense, doesn't it? So now we want to answer the question. The total time, the total flying time was 5 hours. How far apart are the cities? All right. All right, what does that mean, how far apart? We're talking the distance. So finally, you get something that where the answer is just not x. So we don't want to, remember when we solved it, and we said x equals 2? You don't want to say 2. Certainly the cities are not just 2 miles apart. It's talking about the distance right here. Oops, anyone notice I put 3,000? Sorry about that. 300 miles. So here's the distance. Or you could look at it on the picture, there's the distance. So you could say the answer is, let me make it in red, like that. The cities are, everything was in miles, so that's 300 miles apart. Always make sure you answer the question. Don't just write x equals 2. Boy, that's not going to help you at all. And I bet you on a multiple choice test, if you take any of those, 2 would be one of the answers to see if somebody remembers to actually answer the right question. So this is our answer. And again, it's helpful if you try the problem on your own after watching me do it. And then if you get stuck, go back and watch it again. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.